हॅलो बिरारी सर.
यस सर।
सर सुरू करायचं
हो मी तयार आहे तुमच्यावर।
का? ओके ओके सर, ठीक आहे, चालेल. म्हणजे यस, सो गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, अँड आय वेलकम यू ऑल ऑन द फिफ्थ डे ऑफ ऑनलाइन एक्सपर्ट टॉक ऑन रिसेंट अडवान्सेस अँड क्वालिटेटिव्ह रिसर्च इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स, ऑर्गनाइज बाय डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक सायन्स, KTHM कॉलेज, नाशिक. वी हॅव अ एमिनंट अँड व्हर्सटाईल पर्सनॅलिटी टुडे ॲज अ एक्सपर्ट स्पीकर, डॉक्टर VM बिरारी सर. सो आय वेलकम डॉक्टर बिरारी सर ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ ऑर्गनायझिंग टीम. डॉक्टर बिरारी सर विल बी गिविंग अ एक्सपर्ट टॉक ऑन रिसेंट ट्रेंड्स इन मोबाईल कम्युनिकेशन. सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द टॉक आय विल कॉल मिस्टर आकाश सिंग फॉर अ ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ डॉक्टर बिरारी सर. सो मिस्टर आकाश.
Yes, sir. Hello, everyone. Today's session, I introduce to you Professor Dr. Virari, sir, Head of Department of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering at NDMBPS Karmveer at V.G. Thackeray College of Engineering, Nashik. Dr. Virari has completed M.Tech in ENTC in 2005. He got PhD in 2016. He has attended more than 30 seminar, workshop, and FDP program. He has paper published 4 in national level, 7 in international level, and 6 conferences. He also awarded by the best teacher in professional category by Sarvajanik Vidyalaya Nashik, and also awarded by Engineering Achievement Award. By the Institution of Engineers, he has 22 years teaching experience. He is also membership of more professional institution. He awarded by best paper presentation at IEEE sponsored international conference in 2015. Dr. Virari sir worked as a resource person, member of expert committee and administrative responsibilities, judge for Avishkar competition, session chair for conference, member of expert panel in the interview committee for engineering and technology of University of Pune. Expert for group discussions, personal interview in the admission process of MBA. So I request to sir, please start the session.
Thank you, Akash Singh and Dr. Khair. Shall I present?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we'll start. Slide is visible?
Yes, sir. Yes, visible.
So good. I say good afternoon to everyone. And thank you, Kernar sir, for giving the opportunity, and as well as the committee members of all committee, COA, as well as KTHM College. So as for the discussions, we are going to discuss about recent trend in mobile communications. The topic, the purpose of selection of this topic is that presently everyone is using the mobile. Everyone knows, they see the symbols at mobile. Sometimes it is LTE, sometimes VoLTE, sometimes 3G, sometimes H++. And when I discuss this with my students, then they were unable to answer sometimes. And hence, we decided, as related with this topic, that what is the current trend in scenario, the technology what we are using. We must be familiar with this as per technical persons. And related to this, I chosen initially, we will start with the evolutions of mobile generations and its comparison. After that, we will discuss about the overview of LTE systems, the overview of 5G network also. So evolutions of mobiles, if you see this picture, that various mobiles, you might have seen this, the various ways that some mobiles at the initial stage with the very huge size as well as antenna, and recent mobiles what we are using is related with the smartphone. So this evolution is nothing but related with the 1G technology. 1G is moved to the 2G technology, 3G, 3G plus, and E3G and 4G or now upcoming 5G technology. So this evolution started in around 85. Then after, you might have experienced that after 2015 or after 2010, most of the recent trend existence mobile. So mobile is not only for the communication purpose or verbal communication purpose, but it is a computer we are using at our day-to-day life. Without mobile, now it will be very difficult for us to, suppose sometimes if we forget the mobile, then it will be very difficult because everything is now with the mobile things. We can check the emails, WhatsApp messages, Telegram messages, Facebook, Instagram, so many applications we can use the mobile for that purpose. So we can say that initially it begins with the AMS, that is Advanced Mobile Phone Systems, in around 85. And tax, that is that age enhancement in the data rates for the global evolutions. Then WCDMA, wideband, CDMA techniques. After that, modifications in that HSP, that is high speed packet access. And then recently what we are using is the LTE, that is long-term evolution. Optimizations in the same, and ultra mobile broadband is the technique, and in so many cases otherwise.
Hello, sir, I'm sorry to disturb you.
Yes sir, audio.
Sir, there is a problem with your voice, it is not clearly audible. थोड़ा सर म्हणजे एक ब्रेक होते किंवा लांबून वाटते.
नाउ इट इज ऑडिबल.
यस सर, यस.
ओके, आई हैव टू टेक द माइक नियर टू मी. सो इफ यू कंपेयर 1G विद द 5G, वी कैन से दैट इन अराउंड 1970s टू 80s the 1G technology was introduced. Around 90 to 2004, 2G technology was used, and around 2004 to 2010, 3G technology, we were all the evidences of all, and 4G and 5G, that 5G is upcoming, and 4G, what we can say that after 2015 or around 2016, the 4G technology, LTE technology we are using, with the data rate of 2 Kbps moved to 64 Kbps, then up to 2 Mbps, up to 4 GB. We can say that 1 Gbps, and what we are expecting in the 5 is more than that. So initially it was with the analog technology, then moved to the digital, then CDMA with the edge technology, then WiMAX, Wi-Fi, and LTE, and then WWWW is the upcoming for the 5G technology. Initially, it was started with the PSTN, existence public switch telecom network. After that, the 2.5G or near to the 3G, the packet networks, GPRS was introduced. And then with the 4G, internet was introduced as a core network. Initially used with the FDMA as a multiplexing concept, then both TDMA as well as CDMA multiplexing concept. And then now with the 3G, 4G, 5G, all we are using the CDMA concept. Switching, initially it was circuit switching, and circuit as well as packet switching. With the 3G, it was totally changed to packet switching. And now in the 4G and 5G, all the packets we are using. Initially, 1G was introduced with the analog telephone calls. After that, digital phone calls and some messages can be possible. With the 3G technology, we can say that digital phone calls as well as messaging and the data email was possible with the 3G technology. And after that, we can say that all internet services or protocol services, including voice services, are included in the 4G. Now, all VoLT, what we can say that voice over internet, that also we have to focus. Main difference in that initially it was mobility was the problems, then it is modified related with the security and mass adoption. After that, in 3G, we expect more better internet speed. After that also, we are expecting now the faster and broadband at the very low latency. Data should be fast, accessible. And then better coverage and the no drop calls is expecting in the 5G technology. So initially it was poor efficiency, security issue was there. It is modified to limited data rate. And then it is battery use is more in case of existence 4G. And now in 5G, we are expecting node-to-node communication. Node-to-node communication means what? In the present case, the mobile is communicating. When we'll come across the one slide I have prepared for the GSM architectures, in that case, we'll learn that mobile is communicating first to the BTS, BTS to the BSC, BSC to the MSC, and then the process returns again. But whereas in case of 5G, it will be node to node. One mobile can be directly communicated with the another mobile. So fastest can be possible in case of 5G technology. So we can say symbols initially was 2G technology with the GSM with data rate of 14.4 kbps for uplink and downlink. Then GPRS, that is packet radio switch, general packet radio services. After that, age. E, so many times you observe that E symbol at the mobile range tower, what we can see that E plus or E, so that indicate that H technology we are using sometimes in the evening. In the morning sessions, we may observe LTE, it may be VoLTE, but in the evening or late night, it will be dropped down to the H. So sometimes they provide us the facility of 3G, or sometimes it will be of 4G, combinations of that. So that is enhanced data rate for the GSM evolutions with the high speed of 217 kbps for downlink and 108.3 kbps for uplink. After that, UMTS for use for 3G technology, that is universal mobile telecommunication systems, for with the downlink speed of 384 and uplink speed of 128 kbps. Then H, so many times you observe that H symbol in our range that indicate that HSPA, that is high speed packet access with the 7.2 Mbps download speed and 3.6 Mbps upload speeds. After that, H plus, this also we observed, HSPA plus, that is high speed packet access with data rate of 14.4 to 168.8 Mbps for the downlink and 11.5 to 23 Mbps for uplink. After that, LTE 4G technology, that is long-term evaluations, 100 Mbps and 50 Mbps for uplink. 4G LTE-A, that is advanced versions for 1 gigabytes. So these are the evolutions. We can say that mobile technology has evolved from voice focus to the data focus. Now all are the data packages. If we want to recharge our mobile, and instead of voice, all the facilities are available with the data packages. What is the data package? What for how many days it is, and what should be the speed you require and validity for that. Based on that, the rates are differ and not on the. So voice calls are limited because revenue generation is more or use is more in case of data rather than voice. And hence, evolutions, mobile is not now the device only for the communication, but the part of the life. So everything is possible with the help of mobile. Mobile can be used as a remote also to operate the IoT devices. So we can say that this journey begins with the 1980 to now the evidences of 2020, in which analog phone for voice is communicated to the digital with IS-95, with the GSM, then IMT-2005, and now what we are using, the wireless internet mobile systems with multimedia 4G technology. So in evolutions, we can say that we focus on the development of various generations of mobile wireless technology. 0G generally wireless technology was introduced, referred to the pre-cell phone mobile telephone systems, that is the radio telephones that had, some had cars before the advent of the cell phones. The device was placed on the car and the car is moving. It was the concept. After that, 1G, that is analog cellular phone systems, which what we can say that used for multiple cell sites and transfer the call from one site to the next. This was the, you can see, if those that have not seen this picture, you can see this picture consists of huge size of the mobile as well as antenna, around 84. The Bell was developed this centrally controlled base station cell site. And each providing services to the small area only, partially overlapped area can be covered, providing services to the small cells, and system expanded to reduce the transmission power. So we can say that it is modified to the 2G technology, which is nothing but here, the size of the phone is also reduced as well as antenna height is also reduced. In which we can say that 2G mobile phone system emerged using the GSM standards for the digital transmission. SMS facility is possible with the help of 2G technology, generally 2.5G GPRS systems, where it consumes the less battery power, so that helps mobile battery to last long. So digital coding improves the voice clarity and reduces the noise. And digital encryption is provided. What digital encryption? What we are using it for the security purpose. What we can say that. But the disadvantage is that strong digital signals is required for 2G. Hence, again, the modifications in that technology 2.5G GPRS general packet radio systems. Here it is the separate mobile was device defined with the data rate of 56 kbps. And used for wireless application protocol WAP access. If you remember that when you access remotely or when you access with the access point or hotspot, the WAP security code we have to enter for that. That is wireless application protocols we are using. It supports multi-messages, that is multimedia messaging services, as well as for email and web access, www. And 2.75 age enhanced revolutions with the clear and fast transmission with the data rate of 384 kbps speed. And this high speed data networks demands for the data services growing to meet the phone age change. Now antenna is inbuilt as a microstrip antenna systems inside the mobile. Then it uses packet switching rather than the circuit switching. This is the drastic change in that case. Circuit switching dedicated line was required. Now each packet moves separately on the net. So it is multimedia streaming of the radio as well as even on the television's content to the 3G begins from the 3G. Present day we can say that suppose this webinar wants to attend on YouTube or wants to attend on Facebook, so YouTube streaming, so that at the beginning you can listen it, you can record it. So video streaming concept begins with the 3G technology with high speed downlink packet size and that uses high speed packet accesses. So 3.5G plus that uses universal mobile telecommunication systems, normally called as UMTS, with the higher data rate up to 14 Mbps and can be increased with the HSPA plus up to 42 Mbps and 84 Mbps for the 3GPP networks. Now let's focus on the what is the 4G, what we are using the smartphone. for the improvement in the speed, it is 10-fold times with the existence 3G technology. So we can say that the expectations for 4G technology is basically high quality audio video streaming and end-to-end protocols. End-to-end internet protocol is the main requirement in case of 4G. WiMAX standards as well as LTE standards are used that uses IP network, internet protocol network. Thus, we can say that packet switchings can be possible with the LAN, WAN, with the VoIP. So LTE transfer the speed from download to 100 Mbps and can be increases up to 128 Mbps for the WiMAX. So we can say that in summarize, if we can say that evolutions, then 1G only for voice, 2G for voice plus SMS plus basic data, voice plus SMS plus little faster edge technology, then voice plus SMS plus faster data with the 3G technology, all above with the faster data speed up to 3.5G Mbps with 3.5G, 3.75G above faster, all above with the faster data rate of 21 Mbps and LTE, that is faster data rate up to 128 Kbps. So we can say all these are the evolutions, and definitely all who are attending this are the evidences of 3G and 4G technology. I don't know exactly whether you are familiar with the 2G mobile and 2.5G mobile, but definitely I'm sure about that. You are using 3G technology and presently you might have using the 4G also. So you just compared what is the difference between 3G and 4G and what we are expecting from the 5G. So question arises is, what is 4G technology? What is LTE? So many times they use the word LTE technology. Sometimes we remember the full form of long-term evaluations. But what exactly technology is? We can say that. Initially, in the network architectures in the GSMs, we can say that GSM card versus electronic systems network. In that case, data rates, data coverage, technology roaming, and security, and the radiation coverage are the issues. When we discuss this, then we can, because existence 3G, 4G and 5G that uses CDMA, whereas previously they used the GSM technology. So with the GSM, we can say that, what is the difference in both the CDMA and GSM? GSM is with the SIM specific, whereas CDMA is handset specific. If you remember, when the Jio launches the phone, it was a Reliance phone initially, it was closed now. But Reliance, when launches the new technology, the phone with the without that is SIM card was not required. Directly you have to purchase the phone, you can talk. But it has certain advantages as well as disadvantages. That system is outcome until we are using with the GSM networks only. So technology that uses with the GSM with FDMA and TDMA, whereas in case of CDMA, it is CDMA technology. Availability is globally used, easily available as compared to the CDMA, where fewer countries are used with the CDMA technology, with the data rate of 42 Mbps with high speed in GSM, whereas 3.6 Mbps is in the CDMA. Future, we can say that GSM supports transmitting data and voice both at once, whereas CDMA does not support this feature simultaneously. This is the one of the drawback in case of CDMA. We can say that customer information stored in the SIM, whereas the customer information stored in the handset. So network towers in each cell serves the mobile phone, whereas the physical channels, dedicated code for each device is the network which is used for the CDMA. Roaming for GSM, it is worldwide, and that's why till we are using the GSM one in our countries, whereas in some countries still GSM along with the CDMA are using. So frequency band, we must be familiar with this. Presently we are using 800 or called as GSM 900, or it is also called as 1800 or 1900, whereas for CDMA it is single 850 megahertz band. So this all about the comparison between the existing GSM or for the 2.5 GSM system, but 3G, 4G that uses CDMA. So Any doubt, any clarifications required for that before start with the LT? Free field, communicate.
काही क्वेश्चन असतील तर विचारून घ्या.
दिस इज ओनली द बॅकग्राऊंड सो दॅट वी कॅन से दॅट व्हॉट इज द इव्होल्युशन इन दॅट मोबाईल व्हेन वी आर युझिंग द 4G, दॅट व्हॉट वॉज द फर्स्ट जी जनरेशन अँड व्हॉट द हाऊ द इव्होल्युशन टू प्लेस टू द 4G. सो वी कॅन मूव फ्रॉम 4G टू 5G ऑल्सो.
हॅलो सर.
येस
सर, आता आपण म्हणतो की आपल्याकडे 4G आणि 5G जे टेक्नॉलॉजी ते ट्रेंडिंगला चालू आहे.
Yes.
सर, पण आपण जर आता नीट जर चेक केलं स्पीड रेंज मध्ये तर आपला मोबाईल मॅक्झिमम आपल्याला 15 to 20 MBPS देतो. सर मग ही तर 2G ची स्पीड झाली ना, मग आपण काय समजायचं की 2G चालू आहे की 4G चालू आहे?
आपण काही वेळेस फक्त समटाइम्स वी आर युझिंग द 4G टेक्नॉलॉजी टील बिकॉज सो मेनी अगेन द कन्फ्युजन विथ द व्हिओ LTE अँड LTE. इफ यू सी दॅट डिफरंट सर्व्हिस प्रोव्हायडर्स दे आर ऑल्सो क्लेम दॅट we are having the highest speed, then this is the data rate, and that's why while talking I have given you the answer that if you check in the evening where the traffic is very low, the service pro, because you see internet rates are very cheap in India is the cheapest in all over the countries. So whatever the rate what we are using for the internet, we are the cheapest one, and hence this facility they shared with us. Sometimes it provides you the 4G network, otherwise it is mostly 3.5 only. That's why you check on your mobile, you will came to know whether it is the 4G technology, whether it is VoLTE, whether it is H1, H plus, whether it is E. And if you observe carefully, you will came to know that late night, this is changed to 3.5G. And in the morning, again, it is switched from sometimes 4G, or in between that, in daily time also, it is switching from 3.5 to 4G, 4G to 5, and 4G again. The lastly, I covered that point, whether LTE is the 4G or not. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
So it is variations. We say that we are using the 4G network, but actually it is not the truth. For our case, we are not getting the 4G speed also. But there is a reason that data rates as well as we are not ready to pay for that. If the packet rates are your data rates or your what we can say that normal or monthly charges what you are paying for the service provider, they are not able to provide the good quality service at that rate. And if the charges are higher, sometimes we are not ready for that. That both the win-win situations what we are using, they are providing, they say that we are using 4G technology, but equipments at higher ends sometimes not possible. In particularly again, if you go to the rural areas also, this quality is also deteriorating. It varies again where the revenue are generation, they provide the services. This is the business concept. Anyone else? That we can otherwise proceed for the 4G or LTE technology. LTE is a long-term evolutions, is the standard for wireless broadband communications for mobile service devices and the data terminal based on the GSM Edge as well as UMTS HSPA technology. See the combination, that's why when I use the word sometimes again the question to what I remember that answer to your questions. If accessing the mobile, this will come in the VoLTE also, when you are accessing the mobile with data access, and then if voice call comes, your data rate changes. Everyone should note this point, observe this as a technical point, that whenever the data received and whenever the call receives, when we are surfing the data and the call receives, there is a drop in the data rate because bandwidth sharing. And that's why here it is the GSM Edge as well as UMTS HSPA technologies combinedly used in case. So can be avoided in VoLTE, and we are expecting the 5G higher speed for that. So that point I will elaborate later on also. So it increases the capacity and speed using the different radio interfaces. Radio interfaces, one mobile is communicating with the other wireless devices. What we can say, how they are interfaced, how the data is communicating. So for that purpose, various different interfaces are needed. So what are the different various interfaces, that also we have to discuss. So UMTS, so it is the journey from UMTS to LTE, that reduction in end-to-end delay, voice over internet, we can say that. What is EPC in the LTE system, that is Evolved Packet Core. This is small modification. So after these slides, I will show you the GSM architecture. Before that, we'll see the architecture of 4G, then GSM, and then again 4G, so that you can easily compare both. So that you will came to know about the meaning of EPC, that is Evolved Packet Core representations in the LTE network, which was not present in case of GSM network. Multiple nodes can be possible in case of LTE, that is Evolved Based Node called as ENB, Mobility Management Entity, MME, then Home Subscriber Servers, HSS, then Surveying Gateway, HGW, and Packet Data Network Gateway, that is directly controlled in an MME. What is the purpose of this? That also we will see. It is responsible for routing the user plane packets between the different wireless interfaces. So what are the different functions performed by the LTE? First is the mobility management. Mobility management means continuously we are moving. So if you are moving with the vehicle, with the two-wheeler, it may be the four-wheelers, how we cross the sales. We are continuously moving from one sale to another sales. So in that case, mobility management is the main task in case of LTE. So it was in the GSM also. So soft handoff, how it handles. The same it is in case of mobility management. Then verifications, authentications, whether the user is authentic or using the services. See, that's why you might have observed when your data pack is over, you are unable to access your services. The reason is that every time it verifies authentications of the user, whether he has, which services should be provided. So your packet is over, then 8 days you can able to receive the incoming calls, but all outgoing calls are stopped now. So this is verified with the authentications every time, whether the true person is using the phone or not. That is authentic registered person is using the phone also. Then your session managements, sometimes talk time we are top up. So during that time, top up talk times, that 49 rupees, it begins with 49 to higher rates. So what should be the call rate for each session, that is defined. What if you are using the data package, then all the calls are free. And how much you are using the data, based on that, your rates are varies or your data is utilized. So it is what we can say that session management is the main task. Setting up the bearers and the applications, different quality of services, what quality is providing by the LTE, that is also main functions of these systems. So basically it is packet domain service, that is voice over internet protocols on LTE. Again, the TCP/IP, that is transmission control packet, and internet protocol based layers are used. What we are using now, the 5G with the cloud computing, and it will be the networks only, so that your TCP/IP concept will be more broadly utilized during the mobile communications. You can see that higher peak data rates, users throughput up to 100 Mbps and 50 Mbps for uplink with the bandwidth of 20 megahertz. It reduces the latency, that is user plane latency is less than 5 milliseconds, is the term used. Improvement in the efficiency up to 200 active users in the same at the rate of 5 megahertz. So if we compare with the GSM, is around in a single cell, sometimes 989 users are used, but active participations are 128 in case of GSM technology, whereas with the LTE technology, it modifies 128 is moved to 200 active users. Optimized for the low mobility up to the 15 kilometers. Previously, it was over the range of 2 to 3 kilometers because so many times it varies from 2 kilometers to 20 kilometers, the cell sites. Varies again how much the dense area, whether it is rural area, urban area, based on that. But here, in case of LTE, mobility up to 15 kilometers, maximum up to 35 kilometers can be possible. Higher performance with medium mobility, 120 kilometers per hour possible, and high mobility up to, as I told you, 500 kilometers per hour. So you might have observed this when the vehicle is moving with the fast, unable to access the mobile properly. Sometimes voice breaks. Similarly, when you are in the train, so many times voice break occurs when the speed of the train is increased. This can be avoided with the help of LTE technology. Presently, what we are using, partial basis. Coverage up to 30 kilometers, we can say that. So these are the technical terms, but purposely I have added so many technical terms because it is a technical sessions. I'm not giving only the information. So here we can discuss this peak data rate, 100 Mbps for whole LTE networks and 50 Mbps for uploading. Mobility supports up to 500 kilometers per hour. Control panels and the latency is less than 5 milliseconds, whereas control plane capacity is greater than 200 users, and spectrum flexibility up to 20 megahertz. So if you see the architecture, what basically architecture consists of, this is your mobile. I will show you this one. So you can see that. This is LTE mobile. This is user interface, that is wireless interface between mobile and e-node. Now, if you compare this, it is your, I hope you are all you are familiar with the GSM technology. Hello. Are you familiar with the GSM technology? Architecture of the GSM? Anyone can give me the
yes, sir. Please?
Yes. So we can compare this. This is your, in case of GSM, it was nothing but your BTS, whereas BTS is replaced by e-node bits. Then we can see that I have prepared the GSM technology also. This is architectures, what we can see. We'll focus on the GSM first. See, idea will be very clear for you. This mobile phone is communicating. This mobile is communicating to the BTS. BTS is communicating to one or more BSCs. Then, so in one cell, there may be more BTS, but one BSC exists. That BSC is connected to the MSC. That MSC is nothing but what? We can say that mobile switching centers. BTS is base transmission station. BSC is base transmission station controller, or BSC is combining coordinates. And this MSC is connected to the GMSC, gateway MSC, which is connected to the public switch telephone network, or it may be the ISDN, integrated services network. This is one of the important. Most of the industries are using ISDN concept. At home, it is not useful because, in simple words, if I want to add for the ISDN, more than 8 devices or up to 8 devices can be connected to the single telephone line, so that fax, telephony, internet, all can be possible with the ISDN. PSTN or the PDN terms, what we are presently using. Along with this, MSCs are connected with EIR, that is Equipment Identity Registers, Authentications, AUS, Home Location Registers, and Visiting Location Registers. So all that. So here you should compare this with your LTE technology. So what is LTE technology consist of? Now see, this is in LTE, we can say that with wireless interface UU, it is connected to the node B in a cell. It may construct the network. Then that system is connected to the mobility management systems. Then it consists of HSS, PCRF, which is nothing but surveying gateway and gateway of PDN gateway. And then it is connected to the IP network, which is nothing but. Here, this section is shown as an enhanced packet core EPC network. So what is the EPC? Here, this is the main change as compared to the GSM. So what each into the details that we will focus now. So this is the architectures where we can say that this is your mobile phone. This is nothing but universal mobile telephone systems with 3GPP long-term evolutions, user equipments. It's any device that directly connected to end users for communication purpose. It may be your handheld terminal, it may be your laptop on the broadband connection. This is the importance in case of, previously in case of GSM, it was only the mobile phone. But now we can say that with the laptop, any type of the wireless device can be connected to the net architectures. So here, these architectures added with the GPRS tunnel protocols. So here, when it is connected to the e-node, so how it is connected to the e-nodes with the tunneling protocol. As the name indicates, tunneling protocol means according to the compatibility signal travel from your mobile to the BTS, so this node, according to the compatibility, this is the tunnel. Tunnel means traveling the data from that path. The general packets radio services, because the packet switching is concept used, so GPRS, which was used into 2.5G. So within the 3G or 4G network, the GPRS is used for the packet transmissions. If you see, there are two paths exist. The orange color path, it is for the user data, whereas blue color path is shown as signaling messages, whereas not case in case of GSM. So here, control path is the difference, signaling path is the different, and user data plane is moving with the different path. So now, what is e-node? E-node is nothing but, it is the node B radio stations, that is universal mobile termination system networks for the LTE long-term evolutions. It uses this S1 user plane external interface is defined between LTE and E-node for LTE HGW. SIU interface provides non-guaranteed data delivery of LTE. See the terms, it is non-guaranteed data delivery of LTE user plane. So PDU, that is protocol data units, between the E-node B and HGW. This is E-node B and this one is HGW. Don't forget the terms, what we are using. Initially, we have studied these terms. What basically it consists of? HGW, that is serving gateway, and PDN, that is a packet gateway. These are the two terms. See, packet data is handled separately, and the rest of the services, signaling is provided separately, which is the new terms in case of LTE as compared to the GSM. So, this general architecture is what we can say. In that case, E-node is connected to the control path. So blue is shown as the control path and orange is shown as the user path for that path. It uses S gateway and here it is MME that is connected to HSS for the systems, and then with the PGW it is connected to the PDN networks. So now coming back to this architecture part. So E-node, we can say that it is the node for radio base stations for UMTS network, that is Universal Mobile Telecommunication Systems. called as E-node B, or it is also called as ENB, is the radio network node for LTE network, that is long-term evaluations. S1U, that is user plane external interface, it is also called as S1U, and sometimes it is called as SIU, or sometimes it is called as S1U. Between HGW and that is service gateway, HGW means service gateway, and between ENB. So it is non-guaranteed. These services are not guaranteed. So maybe losses may occur. Non-guaranteed. Whereas protocol data unit, PDU, protocol data units between the E-node and HGW, that uses the transport layers to build, as I told you, here it is all the IP based, TCP IP protocols concepts are used. So each layer is performing their own functions. So for that purpose, here it is, the transport network layer is built on the IP transport for the GTPU concept. GTPU is shown here, that is between your HGW, that is service gateway, to your packet gateway. In between that, how the data is moving. Here it is, both are used, S5 and S8 interface. So let's see one by one. GTU, which is nothing more, what is GTU tunnel? That is GPRS tunneling protocols for 3GPP standards. And HGW, that is surveying gateway, that is the main function of surveying gateway, is to, what is the surveying gateway? Route the packets properly. Whatever the user data, routing and forwarding the user data packets, and it is responsible for inter EV handover for the U-plane and provides the mobility between LTE and other 2G networks. Whatever the communication between BTS and BSC, it is only now BSC is replaced by the two terms MME and HGW. HGW, that is service gateway, is provided. This orange, that is for the user data, is moving now from BTS to the service gateway, where how the packets must be routed, what should be the route of the packets, and how they are forwarded, that is taken care by HGW. After that, we can say that between HGW and packet gateway, the two types of the interface, as I told you, 5S and S8, there are two different interfaces are used. This 5S interface is defined between the service gateway and the packet gateway. It is the interface used for non-roaming scenario. There are two types of the scenario, roaming and non-roaming scenario. For the GSM existence of our systems, we can say that if Maharashtra, Goa is roaming free now. Previously, it was not the case. When I want to move from Nasik to Mumbai, I have to change the roaming concept. I have to provide an application to the service provider that I'm moving to the Mumbai from this days to these days. So I need your services. So we can say that roaming. During that time, charges was also different. Mobile roaming charges for incoming as well as outgoing charges was also different. Nowadays, with the Maharashtra Goa, it is roaming free. Everywhere we can see the possible, because of the worldwide network, it is possible for the network can be. But here we can see the two facilities are there. One is S5 interface is used here for the non-roaming scenario, whereas for the service gateway located in home network or roaming scenario with the service gateway, S8 is the protocol used for that purpose. So S5 and S8 is the same interface, but S5 is used for the without roaming, and S8 is when the roaming is exist. So it is a part of EPC network, that is Evolved Packet Coax Network. Read it out with this. Otherwise, it should not be a monotonous. The technical terms I'm discussing.
काही डाउट्स असतील तर विचारून घ्या.
So Packet here is also packet gateway is used nothing but the Cisco packet network gateway. Here is also you have to remember in normal our day to day life within the college or small organizations we are using D-Link or some other. But at the higher generally the Cisco routers and the packets formats are used. So Cisco packet data network gateways are used PGW for the critical network functions for the 4G. Which act as an interface between LTE network and the PDN one. Here it is the terms we can say that. Other packet data such as internet or SIP based IMS networks are used for that. So service gateway and gateway arises. What is the difference between the service gateway and packet gateway? As initially told you, servicing gateway, that is the main function of servicing gateway is routing and forwarding. Whereas PGW, that is PDN gateway, or it is called as packet gateway, is connected node between your equipment, that is your mobile device, or universal mobile equipment, and to the external network. External network means your PDN. For that purpose, HGI is the interface is used between PGW and the external PDN one. That is for external public or for private network where we are connecting. For that purpose, HGI is the protocol or wireless interface is used, which is nothing but similarly to that of it may be for IP or IMS. That is IP multimedia subsystems. IMS is nothing but what? IP multimedia subsystems, that is standard based on architectural framework for delivering the multimedia communication services. Multimedia means what? We can say that nowadays voice, video and the text messaging over internet protocol. Initially, as I told you, circuit switching was the different terms. Now everything with the LTE, everything will now on the slightly when we are moving to the VoLTE, all are nothing but on the voice. So it will be treated as a data term. Voice is also treated as a data part. LTE networks are all IP networks. And this means that they are deliver all the user traffic in the IP packets and provide user always on the IP connectivity. Now, towards the control panel. So we just observed, I will repeat this part. Whatever the information, user data, it is handed over to the BTS, that is ENB. I'm using the word BTS so that you can easily compare it with the GSM. This BTS is handed over to the BSCs, which is nothing but service gateway. Service gateway is handed over to the MSC, which is nothing but what? PDN gateway. Gateway that through this PDN, you can connect it to the external world. And it is called as PDN, ISDN, PSTN and so on. And all for that purpose, all here it is wireless connectivity is there. And for wireless connectivity, here S1U interface, S5 or S8 interface and HGI interface are used so that when mobile data is moving from the mobile unit, so it will be user data is moves in this path to the destinations. Now focus on the control plane, that is various signals. So here we can say that in between service gateway and multimedia, this one interface is used, which is nothing but what GPRS tunneling concept. So GPRS protocol support the exchange of signaling messages between the nodes by creating GTP tunnel. Now question may arise here that signaling. Here it is. I have also used the word signaling messages. Any doubt about the signaling messages? Is it clear to you that what messages are the signal? What is the signaling messages? Unless until signal is active, signaling messages, your communications cannot begin. Initially, what remember in around 90s to 2000 also. But in Nasik, I'm giving the examples of Nasik, the telephone exchange. So Someone may, suppose some my friend is working, may enter into the telephone exchange, and then I can use that telephony systems of someone, because the exchange or the connectivity are exist in the exchange. I can use my personal calls by using another connections or anyone connection who is the subscriber. And then I can make a call. I can make a national or international call also. In the Nasik, you might observe that in the Pawan Nagar, the scam was there that you can make a call to Dubai with the normal rates. Then there was a huge crowd on that booth, telephone booth. Later on, in 1997, the signaling system was introduced, so that when the mobile one unit is connected to the another unit, the signal is established between exchange, and this thing established by the exchange only. Then and then one user is able to communicate with another user. Until signaling does not exist, it will be difficult for the user to make conversations, and this facility provides the security part indirectly. Hence, we can say that it is the tunneling between that is service gateway and multimedia gateway that uses the signaling message, of course, the GPS tunneling, that is GP, is 2.5G technology that provides interconnect between the various network interfaces. C that is added at the end of to indicate that the control, GT control, C is added as for the control purpose. So this information now reach to the MM and HSS. MM, that is mobility management entity, and home subscribers. These are the two terms with nothing but at the control, which is your home location area. It is similar to that of at the GSM. And in between that, S6A, that interface is used that enables the transfer of subscriptions and authentication data. So unless and until the data is not authenticated, your user data from upper end, though it is connected, not able to activate unless and until authentication is verified with the mobility management and the subscriber servers. Once it is agreed. So what it agrees, it uses the AAA interface. What that AAA interface? Authentications, and systems which is involved in that case. It is called as AAA interface between MME and HSS. It provides the transfer of quality policies, the charging rules. So whether the subscriber is able to make a call, whether charging their subscription is valid or not, whether the number is authentic or not. Authentic means what? Sometimes if your mobile is number registered for the theft, then that number, once it is registered for the theft, then at the service provider ends, it is blacklisted. So such a type of the services are not able to, or such type of the calls are not provide services to that. So it is, we can say that verifications and authentications and authorizations are involved in this activity. After this, the diameter of used in the LTE, which is nothing but as I told you, accounting authorizations and authentications protocols, which is used between the OSI model with the TCP and the, that is, transport layers for security purpose. So that protocol diameters is the successor of RDS, that is the remote authentication dial protocol that runs over UDP. So this is what we can say, that overall architecture is how they performs with the 4G. With, see here it is purposely, you observe that it is 3G. Mention it is 4G, but actually it is 3G LTE. Or it is SA network. It may be connected with the IMS, it may be connected to the 3G or 3.5G, or it may be the vector sales, that is the sales used within the small area. System architecture evolutions is the network architecture designed to simplify LTE networks that establish the flat architecture similar to other IP-based communication protocols. As told you, femtocell is the smaller cellular base station designed for the use in residential or the small corporate environments. So suppose within the office, we connect our own network. So for that, we call as femtocells. Then IMS, that is IP multimedia subsystems, standalone systems that is used in the network for the gateway. Then basically architecture, if you observe this, it is nothing but in simple way, we can say that these are the number of nodes, same as that of the BTS. NB is nothing but the node B stations. They are connected to the RNCs, that is radio network control, same as that of the BSCs. Then BSCs are connected to the gateways. So here it is serving GPRS supports because it is for the packet transmissions and hence serving HGNS is used, and then serving HGNS is provided to the GGSN, which is nothing but the gateway GPRS support nodes. And this is nothing but if you see the EPC, that is evolved packet port, one part is MME, just we have seen the servicing gateway and packet gateway. Both are connected to the every network, or all the BTSs are connected to both. That is mobility management entity, as well as service gateway, as well as packet gateway, packet data network gateway, or previously it was all the BTS within the BSC. One BSC may be connected to the more than two BTSs. But here, if you observe that, that is mobility management entity connected to other towers also, and hence with the S1 interface, what we can say that EUTRAN formats, which is nothing but we can say that UMTS terrestrial radio access networks, which is used. So both the networks are shown in the similar way as compared to the previous one. That GPRS core network, which is nothing but GGSN together with HGSN, that handle the packet transmissions between GPRS and GSM, is connected to the GIN base stations that connected through LU interface, or it may be called as UTRAN interface. So which is nothing but radio network controller that here is shown as the RNC. RNC is governing the element of UMTS radio access, which is responsible for controlling the node base stations connected to it. So the similar type of the network can be shown with the different, as initially told you, it may be your mobile phone, it may be your device, it may be your laptop, it may be your different node phones and so on. So how they are connected, and each network is connected to each others with the different E-nodes in the first layers, and then once you entered into the EPC area where MMS, RA, then servicing gateway, multimedia, mobility management, then it is connected to the PDN network. So for that, as we discussed, network protocols are used. Stream control transmission protocols is badly needed in case of LT, and that's why we can say that in VoLT or LT concept, the streaming is possible, which provides multi-roaming supports where one or both ends connections exist. It also uses IP addresses, where LTE network is used to provide guaranteed message delivery between MME and E-node. SCTP allows the multiple message streams to be exchanged on the single STP connections. This is what we can say that. Then another 6A, that is S6A interface, that also uses the SCTP, same terms. Then they also uses S11, that uses UDP data user datagram protocols for the use for the communications, but low latency is used, but typically used for the IP and TCP IP. UDP protocols for the LTP, When UDP packet arrives at the receiving host, it is delivered to the receiving UDP agent and identified by the destination port field in the packet. So first, the simulation is carried out for the LTE2 modulator with the NS2, that is network simulator 2, and using the UDP, constant bit error traffic is maintained in this network. Then S5, S8 interfaces, they are used again the UDP and IP. S1U interface again use the UDP and IP. And then physical layers in the LTP are OFDM, orthogonal physical frequency division multiplexings, multiple input, multiple outputs, then new access method schemes that are used. Then frame structures, they are used with the CDMA CD concept or CA collision avoidance. I'll not focus on that. The details. Here the question arises, is 4G and LTE are the same or different? What's your opinion? Here it is LTE, sometimes known as 4G LTE. See, basically LTE is the different terms and 4G is the difference. Frequently we are using the 4G means LTE. But small difference is there that I want to highlight. LTE, sometimes known as 4G LTE, is the type of 4G technology. That is long-term evaluation system, lower than true 4G, but significantly faster than 3G, which originally had data rates measured in kilobits per second rather than megabits per second. So this was the question that someone asked me during that time, that actually we are not getting the speed of 4G. The reason is that we are not true 4G, we are not using. It is 3G or 3.5G or sometimes 3.75G. Sometimes it is E plus, sometimes it is H plus, sometimes it is LTE symbols, sometimes it is VoLTE symbols we observed in the towers, so in our network indicators. So based on that, we can say that theoretically we use the word LTE, but it is not the fact. Then LTE and VoLTE is same? No. Here it is generally LTE is also called as 4G. Generally, I use the word. But VoLTE is called as voice over long-term evolutions. It supports the 4G network. VoLTE, you can enjoy the data connectivity while calling. If you remember previously, I discussed when you are calling, connectivity differs in case of 3G network. So speed of 3G and 4G are shown like this. 5G, it is very high. 4G it is moderate, whereas 3G nowadays we can see it is low. So any doubt with the 4G technology? Try to cover the architecture part so that any doubt related to that I can focus on that. Otherwise we can compare this with the 5G. What is the 5G upcoming technology that we came to know about? Yes. Simple comparison, if you see the architecture BTS with the E node, BSCs with the SA gate, then HSS is nothing but your home locations, MSCs are nothing but similarly in that case PD gate, P gate and so on. Functionality is remain same, only the technologies and hence interfaces are the different. Data rate is the important one. What the difference between 4G, LTE and VoLTE? VoLTE is nowadays on the TV also so many times we have, that is VI is the true VoLTE. VoLTE important is that data will not be suffer when the calling. Whereas in case of your 4G network or in case of LTE network simple, in your mobile also if you check your setting, if your latest smartphone only will support VoLTE, older, that is 2 years back phone, may not be support VoLTE, tower, your network may be of VoLTE, but your device will not support, and hence whenever someone make a call to you, when you are receiving the call, definitely doing that internet packet rate is D4. That is the main difference between the true 4G and LTE network. And in case of
You mean what are the voice if I am presently using VoLT? So in VoLT, voice is also used as a format. And so definitely no arises of the divider here. Just see this, I forget to explain this part basically. Here, the two terms are there. One is related with the packets and other is related with the data. When the packets are moving and the terms are diverse in that case. Whereas in case of VoLT, it is not possible. All the voice is also transmitted as a data packets format. And it's consistently their speed can be achieved with the help. If any questions, otherwise we'll move to the 5G network. If you compare 4G with the 5G technology, then opportunities and 5G requirements, because 5G deployment somewhere else is in the process, and we are not truly be using this. In some techniques, 5G are using it. And then what are the descriptive technologies used in the 5G that we have to focus? Without hesitations, you can talk, you can ask the questions. If you found any silly question, that you can ask the questions.
You are free to ask the questions. Please ask without hesitation.
So all things are getting also positively. So let's compare this is again, I use this site that 1G, 2G, not necessary to repeat again, up to 4G, but 4G and 5G, we can say that 2010 to now, and what we are expecting upward now will be the upcoming 5G technology with speed up to 10 Gbps. Advanced LTE technology is expected fastest, the super fast mobile speed with low latency, and the network formation critical applications, particularly in case of IoT and multimedia, and autonomous driving car systems, smart healthcare applications, the 5G will be very, very useful for us. So we can say that mobile broadband services are used up to initially with 700 megahertz with the LTE digital band, 800, 900 used with the 3G, with HSPA with LTE, 1800 originally used in the GSM CDMA. Then in LTE it is used 2100 megahertz, then WiMAX it is used 2300 megahertz, and the new capacity band in the LTE up to 2500 megahertz. With comparison of 4G and 5G, we can say that 10 to 100 times speeder than the existing telephone networks. Latency is less than 20 milliseconds. Remote surgery, virtual reality, augmented reality, for that all the applications will be badly needed and very, very useful for that. Coverage from small area to the larger area. Gigabyte technology, what we can say, MIMO, that is mini inputs. Anti-concepts we are going to do. Most important is that millimeter wave, mm wave spectrum. I think you might have visited the GMRT, Naranga. If not, do visit. How they are using the millimeter wave antenna frequency for the research work. I came to know about that. So millimeter wave concept used in the 5G technology, moving from the 3 kilohertz to 6 gigahertz, 300 gigahertz spectrum I am showing with the application. See the TV, radio, mobiles, then this is MIMO type antenna system, then automatic car driver systems, augmented reality and virtual reality with 300 gigahertz. These are the, we can say that 5G spectrums and it coverage implementations are there. This is massive MIMO antenna type system. See, this is, we can say that, see the antenna up to 256 antenna elements will be used, so that will cover the huge area. So definitely the higher data rate will be there, increase the capacity for the multiple users, and better cell edge and indoor user experience. Presently in some cases now we can say that not in the range, some area we are not getting the range, in the dense area we are not getting the range, but that problems can be easily solved with the 5G technology, because they are using multi users, massive MIMO, multiple inputs, multiple outputs concept. So what technology are used in the 5G? Briefly I am explaining this, not going into the details, but you should be familiar with this. That's only the device centric architecture is the important part. Millimeter wave frequency range, massive MIMO technology, smarter devices, and native support to the machine to machine. As I told you, node to node communications can be possible, which will be very, very, very evolution if one mobile is directly communicating with the another mobile. So what is device centric? It is, we can say that total architecture will be changed now for the 5G. Existing scenario will be the change. Changes in the 5G, new architecture concept will be there. Uplink and downlink link, as well as control channels, data channels that uses on the ad hoc basis, node to node, every node able to communicate. Now, in existence, suppose we are sitting in the same chamber, in the same room, in the same classroom, in the same premises, but in the existence case, what we observe that our mobile is communicating to the BTS, BTS to BSC, BSC to the MSC, and then MSC find out the exact route of the destinations and alert, inform to the BSCs, BSC is handed over to the BTS, and BTS handed over to the mobile. So this is the long journey. One mobile can be directly communicate with another mobiles. So that is the drastic change. Only the security issues are there, but definitely there is a solution for that. So that uses node on the ad hoc basis. That is the concept what I explained to you. Millimeter, we can say that microwave spectrum is limited and inadequate, whereas it is abundant in case of millimeter wave. That already used in the IEEE 802.11 AD standards for use, and in use in the niche applications such as small cell backhaul, small cells area, very, very small cell area. This type of applications can be utilized, particularly for the Amazon, eBay, AliExpress, Hotstar, what we are using on the YouTube, all they are using OOT channels for the streaming applications, WhatsApp, Messengers, Snapchat, Hangout, all they are using these technologies. And Massive MIMO is the massive multiple input, multiple output proposes very large number of antennas for the specially multiplex data. It requires major changes in architectural changes in the design of microwave stations. So existing scenario will be changed. Existence antennas, existing infrastructures may not be suitable for 5G. Smarter device, 2G, 3G, 4G have complete control at the infrastructure side. This mobile will not use for 5G, need to be modified with the new technology. So 5G systems will be developed intelligent at the device side. It could allow device-to-device connectivity, and for this it requires changes at the component and architecture level. This existence architecture not suitable. Mainly native supports for machine-to-machine communications, massive number of lot of data rate devices, sustaining minimal data rates in the virtually all circumstances, and very low latency with the data transfers. So this is all about with the 5 descriptive technologies used in the 5G. It will be the upcoming technology. Reliance Jio is already working on that. They are also started with the Reliance Mint Jio, I'm talking about. 6G, they are deploying 5G in some area, and 6G they are thinking of ahead. So this is my side. If anything, because time allocated to me up to 1:30, so I prepared accordingly. And hence, I think I covered up to the required 4G technology as well as 5G technology.
So thank you very much, sir. If you have any doubts, you can ask the questions. Otherwise, it's in from my side. Thank you, sir.
So thank you. Dear participants, if you are having any questions, please ask.
You can ask general questions, sir, on the mobile if you have any doubts also.
Sir, what is the difference of Wi-Fi and mobile data? Hello, sir.
I couldn't get the question. Wi-Fi and mobile data means?
Difference, sir. What is the difference? Wi-Fi and mobile data.
Wi-Fi is nothing but what, in that it is the range provided to you. Within the range, any devices or how many devices are connected, everyone will get the connectivity. It is the access point similar. Wi-Fi is nothing but it is the access point providing to you the services. Data is the what your mobile supports. Data rate, your what technology you are using, based on that we can say that the data varies, data rate varies. It depends upon the applications. Suppose presently we are using with the Google Meet, and if the same Meet we are arranged on the Teams, and if we arrange in on other platform, the each is having the different data rate according to that. The data consumption is also different. If you are watching it on the YouTube, if it is video on, the data rate is the different. If only audio on, the data rate is the different. Wi-Fi is the providers, it is the service providers. Indirectly, it is a wireless network. When you are within the range, you are able to access that. It is the access point. Hope you are getting my question answer.
Anyone else?
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, data transmission, how wired hoto ki wireless hoto purnapane?
In which case? If it is mobile to mobile, what I told you initially, if you go through this network, check this one, this slide, I will go to the GSM architecture and then we'll move to the 4G also. In 4G, it is everything is wireless, observe that. Everything is wireless, and that's why I trace on the interfaces. S1U interface, S1 MME interface, S5 interface, HG interface. Now after this PDN, it may be wired, but here with the UE, that is UMTS equipment, that is your mobile equipment, to the PDN, it is wireless. If you compare this with the, see, GSM architectures, from mobile to BTS is wireless, but BTS to BSC, it may be either connected with the wired or it may be with the microwave also, depends upon that. So what technology you are using, based on that technology, you are connecting to the wired, and that's why 4G technology is nothing but the packet switching only. Whereas previously, with 2.5G, it is all the packet switching, but particularly in case of 4G, it is all on the packet switching or internet. So IP concept is used, which is nothing but if needed, when moves on the net, it is, we can say that on the wired, but mostly with the before PDN to the your device, it is wireless technology. So you can compare this architecture with this architecture. After this point, it may be connected to the your wired network, but up to this IP networks, here it is wireless network. And that's why all the interfaces, what I explained, all these are the wireless interfaces, which is nothing but the part of enhanced packet core, EPC network. Basically, this is the only diagram we can see that. This one is GSM to UMTS and UMTS to LTE EPC. So what is EPC? EPC is nothing but this network. This is the EPC network. This is the EPC network. Yes, anybody?
एनीबडी एल्स, अजून काही क्वेश्चन्स आहेत का? यू यू कॅन आस्क एनी क्वेश्चन रिगार्डिंग मोबाईल कम्युनिकेशन. मोबाईल कम्युनिकेशन संदर्भात कुठलाही प्रश्न तुम्ही विचारू शकता. सो आय थिंक सर देर आर नो मोर क्वेश्चन्स.
यस सर, यस सर,
इट सीम्स. सो
यू कॅन स्टॉप.
यस यस. सो थँक्यू व्हेरी मच सर फॉर अ नाईस प्रेझेंटेशन. You have started from the evolution of mobile generations and focused on 4G LTE and also given the comparisons of different generations spectrum requirement, and you also clear the doubts of some of the participants. So I hope the guidance you have given will be a helpful for our participants to make better use of the mobiles and smartphones. So for vote of thanks, I will call Anjali Pause. Anjali Pause.
Yes, sir. Hello, everyone. First of all, good afternoon to all. On this meaningful session, I would like to present the vote of thanks. I got this golden opportunity to thank to the respected key speaker of this session. I would like to first say today's key speaker, Dr. V.M. Birari, who have delivered this meaningful session on recent trends in mobile communication and share your knowledge with us. Thank you so much, sir, for making this session very interesting. I would also like to thank our respected head of department, Professor S.S. Dempsey, sir, for your guidance and moral support always. I am happy to express a vote of thanks to our professor who have made this expert talk series for us with a great success through their dedication. I also thanks to our coordinator, Dr. A.G. Khena, sir, for organizing this expert talk series. Finally, I would like to thank all the students who attend this session. Once again, thanks to all. Thank you, sir.
Thank you all. Thank you for patience listening.
Sir, thank you very much.
Yes, thank you. Sir. Thank you.
So, second session will start at 1:45 p.m.